You're watching the morning news on 10. Lab tests by consumer watchdog Choice have revealed concerning levels of a dangerous chemical in a range of popular canned foods, including baby food. The chemical known as PBA or bisphenol A has been linked to a number of illnesses such as infertility and heart disease. Joining me now for more on this is Christopher Zinn from Choice. Christopher, good morning to you. I actually looked up some of the scientific studies on this particular chemical. It's also linked to attention deficit hyperactivity, brain development in babies, the female reproductive system, and may even have an adverse effect on the prostate gland. This is a nasty little sucker of a chemical. Why is it there?
Because there's this ongoing argument about what is a safe dosage level, and the food regulators and the food industry say it's yay high, but we would argue that there's been an increasing amount of reliable science that really says it should be actually not this much lower, really thousands of times lower. And this is an ongoing debate. We would say now that argument has really crossed a line where we have to say that it's about time the food industry, one, agreed to reduce and stop the use of BPA in food packaging, because there are alternatives, and two, the government needs to step in terms of the food regulator and stop its use as well.
Christopher, how is this used in food packaging?
Particularly in terms of cans, cans have a plastic lining, and BPA is what's called a plasticizer, so that's flexible, but it can leach into the food. And again, at microscopic, very low levels. You've mentioned some of the health effects. As I've said, it's a very contentious area of science, but we'd say the question mark has grown bigger and bigger over this chemical over the years. And really, it's a question perhaps of the precautionary principle that we just move to other kinds of packaging. Plastic gives us great benefits, but we learn through times there are certain chemicals that do us great harm as well.
The bizarre thing is that it's known that this chemical in even very small quantities can have a big impact on newborn babies, yet it's still used in their food packaging and I believe also even in baby bottles, is that correct?
Yeah, and look, Heinz, to their credit, as a result of our tests, have announced that they are going to phase out BPA in terms of the can lining that they use, and some of the other canneries here are doing the same. So we actually see people power, if you like, consumers demanding a change, are pushing that. But it is in terms of babies' bottles. You can now buy ones which say they are BPA free. The issue is BPA actually does make them harder and tougher. So without BPA, they can be scratched, and that's why you've got to be careful if you have a scratched one to dispose of it and get a new one. But I think most people, when, as you have done, have read reliable websites on this issue, would have some concerns and would take what steps they can to avoid it.
Okay, Christopher, thanks for keeping up the pressure. Christopher's in there from Choice. Thanks.